Welcome to Jimmy Bowen and Friends. Each week's episode features Jimmy Bowen and a special guest like John Schneider, Cody McCarver, Jake Hoot, and more. Today's guest is Ken Wilber. Now, here's Jimmy Bowen.
Well, thank you, folks, and welcome to the Jimmy Bowen and Friends show this evening. We thank you so much for tuning in with us. We've got a great artist coming on here a little bit. You'll hear a lot about Mr. Ken Wilber will be here. He's from upstate New York. Great singer, songwriter. He's amazing. Can't wait for you to hear him. I come from a bluegrass background and originally, and we cut a song called Early Morning Rain, old Gordon Lightfoot tune. And so it's going to be kind of a mixture, a little grass sounding with a little bit of the electric sounding. And so we hope that you enjoy it. Let's kick her off, boys.
There's more Jimmy Bowen and Friends coming up right after this short break. Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
Welcome back, folks, and thanks for tuning back in with us. Our guest tonight comes from upstate New York. He has an actor, theater experience, singer, songwriter, a wonderful guy, and we love him to death, and thank you so much for being here. Please make welcome Mr. Ken Wilber with us.
Thank you for having me.
Glad you could be here.
Me too.
Glad you could be here. So tell us what you've been up to. You've been doing a lot of stuff.
Absolutely. I knew I was coming on here, and I started thinking about, like, God, you know, what do I really want to talk about? And in doing so, I started kind of thinking about, you know, where my life has gone. And, you know, when you start thinking about the trajectory that your life has taken you, you start realizing that there are little tiny things that you've done in your life that at the time seem completely insignificant. And then later on, when you look back, you're like, wow. You know, so for instance, you know, I started out, I took a weird route, you know, into being here playing music. I've always loved music, but I started out doing theater. And when I started thinking about it, everything in my entire life that I have right now is owed completely to doing that. I met my wife doing a production of The Music Man for some small community theater that I never even intended to even have anything to do with. They just called me up, and all of a sudden I was like, yeah, all right, I'll do it. Boom. Next thing you know, I meet my wife, and somebody actually reminded me of this the other day. They were like, hey, you know, when you first did that show, you said, you know, after meeting your wife for about 2 days, you said, I'm going to marry her. And you did. So I met my wife, Amanda, and I also have two beautiful children, Ava and Charlotte, and all that is because of theater. And then
there you go. There you go. That's neat. That's a neat story, my friend.
I was fortunate enough to get to play the legend Hank Williams Sr. in a production of Hank Williams' Lost Highway.
Ah.
That was amazing. And one of the guys who played my bandmates actually found out I was working on my first album up in New York, and he said, hey, come on into my studio, you know, and we'll help you out. And I finished a record there. He ended up having a Nashville connection. He sent it down here, and that's why I'm standing here at the moment, you know. So everything is all connected.
Everything's connected. So from there, did you get into the songwriting?
Oh, well, I'd written some songs on my first album. I mean, I've been writing songs for years. Some of them were pretty good. Some of them were pretty terrible. You know, I think that kind of goes for everybody, really. You know, yeah. When you're first starting out, it's trial and error. But, you know, I wrote about 75% or co-wrote of my first album, Rolling My Own, which is available on iTunes and Spotify. Shameless plug there.
We want to know where we can find you, man. That's what we want to know.
Great.
Now, the song you're going to perform first, you wrote it, correct? Or no, you're not?
No, I did not, actually. Huh. It was written by Sonny LeMaire, who was my producer down here, and also, I believe, Brian Keith Burns was, you know, Trick Pony fame. And it's a great little tune. It's called If I Was a House, and it's very, very patriotic, and it's just very visceral with a different imagery and all that, and I just love it.
Well, that's great. We can't wait to hear it. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ken Wilber.
If I was a house, I'd be a double wide with an old pickup truck parked right outside. And I'd fly the red, white, and blue way up high. If I was a house, I'd be a double wide. If I was a road, I'd be red clay dirt, carving through the cornfields cut from Mother Earth. And I'd hold the tractors on my shoulders on their way to work. If I was a road, I'd be a red clay dirt. Pure and simple, that's the way I'd be. Just like it was handed down to me. If I was a river, I'd run 1,000 miles. I'd roll past cities, towns, and countryside. I'd carry coal and steel down that great divide. If I was a river, I'd run 1,000 miles. Pure and simple, that's the way I'd be. Just like it was handed down to me. was a country, I'd be the USA, where there's a statue in the harbor lighting up the way. And I'd open up my arms and be damn proud to say, if I was a country, I'd be the USA. A double wide with a red clay dirt road passing by, with a mighty flowing river rolling on its way underneath the stars in the USA. Na 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 na.
Don't go away. Jimmy Bowen and Friends will be right back. Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
Ken, that was wonderful, my friend.
Well, thank you.
That was great. Dude, I love that song. I love that song. Now, kind of go into a little bit about the song that you've got. It's a single, right?
Yes. This next song we're going to do for you is it's a little tune called Freedom Song. And at the time we're doing this, it's current single. And I'm really proud of it. It's actually one of my favorite songs on the project that we've been working on. And we got ready to get in the studio, and my producer, Sonny, sent me a lot of songs, and which I'm grateful for, because, you know, nothing makes me happier than having a lot of choices, because choices are good. And this song just jumped out at me, and I was like, hey, what is that? You know, it just was really, really edgy and had a nice southern rock feel to it, and really loved it. And they didn't tell me this. I mean, maybe they assumed that I knew, and I actually didn't at the time. Went in and we did our cut on it, and then afterwards we're kind of in the studio mixing, and they were like, "Yeah, Blackberry Smoke did this song," and I was like, "Who?" And they were like, "Blackberry Smoke," and I'm like, "Why haven't I heard of them? They sound really cool." So I went out and I just happened to be at a record shop, bought all their stuff, and I'm listening to it. And I'm like, "Wow, these guys are amazing!" You know, so I'm so glad I got to do one of the songs that they had done. So I'm a huge super fan now of that band.
That's cool. That's cool. Great song. Looking forward to hearing it, my friend.
Well, thank you,
Mr. Ken Wilber.
Soothing my soul
with a fishing pole. That's what I love. So put me on a highway, the interstate, a dirt road, to any place, as long as I'm a long gone, chasing down some blue skies in my old truck. Tune the world out, turn the radio up, and sing along. As long as I'm long gone, chasing down some blue skies in my old truck. Tune the world out, turn the radio up, and sing along, sing along, sing along to this freedom song.
So much.
We'll be back with more Jimmy Bowen and Friends in just a moment. Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
And welcome back, folks. Thank you so much. Hey, give a big hand for our guest, Ken Wilber. He was great, wasn't he? Loved his show. We're going to say good evening to you tonight. We're going to do a song here that I really like, and you're probably going to recognize it. I've always loved this tune. I actually did a bluegrass version of this song. And actually, if you really want to know the truth, as bluegrass is concerned, it was a number one requested song in Ireland when we recorded this several years ago. So we didn't make a whole lot of money off of it. But it was kind of cool, though, knowing you had a number one bluegrass song in Ireland. So. But anyway, we slowed it down a little bit and we recorded. We're going to say good evening to you folks tonight. And thank you so much for tuning in with us and look forward to seeing you next round. Hope y'all enjoy. One called Love Will Keep Us Alive.
Love.
folks. Thank you.